Good evening, Wisconsin, and welcome to Channel3000.com's Red Zone stream of Wisconsin High School football. I'm Ole Yeager, and in just a few minutes, the 2019 football season will begin with the DeForest Norskies kicking off to the Edgewood Crusaders, who are coming in as visitors tonight. And this, the inaugural game of the 2019 high school football season. And I cannot imagine a better day weather-wise to kick off the football season. You know, typically your August starts, you get that muggy first couple of games. Not tonight, a beautiful upper 60s. The sun is out, tucked behind this wonderful facility we have here at DeForest. And it looks like the season's about to get underway with a kickoff from DeForest off of the leg of number 54, Bennett Gitgerton. Plays offensive line and moonlights as a kicker. And we're underway. Back to receive is Daniel James. He muffs it. DeForest is all over it. Makes the play at the 1 yard line. So a tough start for Edgewood here off the way, but wonderful special teams play, capitalizing on that mistake, and you can't ask for a better start than that. So the DeForest defensive unit will take up here. Looks like the ball's actually going to be moved up to the 4 yard line on forward progress. And here we go, underway here. Looks like the Crusaders are lining up. Two men split out right, one down to the left here. Shotgun formation, one back. The snap, handoff, drive up the middle. Short gain, if any, brought down by a host of Norskies. Looks like they'll credit them a yard gain on the play. Good swarming defense from a sizable defensive line here from DeForest. Saw good penetration on that play from Colby Hartig. Shotgun formation again. This time they're going to go with the option. Quarterback keeps it. Makes about a 2 or 3 yard gain, breaks some tackles. He's brought down at about the 11. That's Marcus Thielen. Showed some athleticism there. You know, it's not often you can see that a quarterback that's comfortable right off the bat running that kind of run pass option type deal. But that's what they were doing. He was holding onto the ball. He was looking at his options downfield, decided to keep it. Turned out to be a good decision. Now it's third with 3 yards left to go. They're going to stick with that shotgun. Thielen has no backs. They got an empty backfield here. Trips outright. Man in motion. Coming across, fake handoff. Thielen goes behind it, up the gut. He may have been close on the keeper there. We'll see where the spot is. And we're just short. Very close play. And that'll bring out the Crusaders punt unit on the 4th and 1. So a good 3 and out off the bat off of a great special teams play by the Norskies, and they're right on track, looking like they haven't missed too many steps as would be expected after a tough finish last year, being eliminated in the second round of the playoffs by the division rival, the Wanakee High School defending champions. So the Crusaders fake it. They've got the punter rolling out right. He decides to tuck it and catch the punt, but it looks like interference as the Crusaders bumped up right against the return man. I got to be honest, I haven't really seen something like that before. He must have lost track of who was going to be receiving the punt, or maybe he thought they called a poison of some sort, but that's going to be costly as it wasn't a super effective punt. It looked like the punter held onto the ball, rolled right. Not entirely sure of his intention, if it was a fake, if he was going to keep it, but he ends up punting on the run. It's a short punt of about 20 yards or so, maybe make it 25, but the penalty is going to tack on a couple. In the first couple of weeks of football, you're going to see those kind of plays made. Guys are playing positions for the first time that they've never played before. Guys are playing high school football for the first time.
15-yard penalty will put it at the Edgewood 25-yard line.
So a 15-yard penalty has been assessed. And DeForest will pick it up on the Crusader 25-yard line. They go with a shotgun set. The snap, off tackle, makes a couple guys miss. Cuts it up. Gets up to about the 24-yard line.
Well done to play by Andrew Sisal.
Andrew Sisal on the tackle there. And Mason Kirchberg on the run.
Gain of 9 on the play, second and 1.
So second and 1 after a gain of 9. DeForest will stick with a shotgun approach. Two men out left, one man split out right. They'll elect to pass. He's got a look down the field. Intercepted. Jumped the route, and he's got some room to run. Tackled by.
Pass is intercepted.
But that was a wonderful jump play. They looked past. They had a crossing route coming across the field. The safety jumped down on it and was able to return it for about 20 yards. That'll be credited to Marcus Taylor. So they'll begin first and 10 from the Edgewood 36, getting the ball back after a rather uneventful first drive. Again, Thielen will be sticking with the shotgun formation. This time he's going to roll out right. Plants, throws across his body. DeForest almost with a chance to get it back is number 23, Devin McGlee. So it's second and 10 for the Crusaders. So a quick start here. You could expect to see some holy football here and there. But for the most part, the Crusaders look like they have a great edge in terms of this kind of tricky offense that it seems to be big play material. Now they just have to work out some of the kinks here, obviously. Shotgun with four receivers. He's looking to pass underneath and on the grab. That's going to be Marcus Thielen, who's made a couple of plays here in the early running. Looks like they split a little bit of time at quarterback and wide receiver. A multi-talented athlete. Also spend some time on the defensive side of the ball. You know, in high school, you get those special athletes like that. So, and the quarterback now will be Dylan Walton. He's going to pass. The pocket collapses. He runs up the middle, gains about 6, and he'll get the first down on third down. Nice conversion on a broken play for the Crusaders. And that moves the chains for the first time of the day for them.
First and 10, Edgewood.
And it looks like that interception may have gotten them a little momentum. Crucial in this early part of the game. Now the key is, can they capitalize here on first and 10, taking it up at the 51-yard line, or excuse me, the 46-yard line. Hand off to Andrew Stigel. He's gonna work out right, get wrapped up at about the line of scrimmage. They'll spot it for a loss of 1. Second and 11.
Loss of a yard on the play, second and 11.
So far, we're about halfway through the first quarter, still scoreless. Both teams trying to catch their footing here. Crusaders have Dylan Walton in the backfield. Shotgun snap. He'll hand it up to Stigel, who will bounce off a tackle. He'll lose another yard. So that's third and 12. Two uneventful runs. That defensive run stop for DeForest is imposing. Someone is penetrating on every single play so far. And when you don't have anywhere to run as a runner, you're looking for lanes, you're looking for broken plays. And maybe that'll get you a couple of yards in the first quarter. But over the course of a game, it's really hard to win when you can't protect your run plays. So third and long here. And the Crusaders have trips out left. The pass, a lot more penetration, and it looks like it'll be a sack. Casey Noble. on the sack.
From Trey Warren.
A lot of penetration there from this team here. It was, so far that's the story of this drive. Outside of that kind of broken play run to get that first down, and even on that, in that case, there has been a Norski in the backfield every single snap. So, Phelan will go back to punt, truly a multi-talented player. And on the return, he'll make a move. Marlon Sisternik. He's got it all the way up to the 50. A return of about 30 yards, but there's flags on the play. We'll wait to see what that is. They look like they could be at the around the 30-yard line, close to where the snap was caught. It'll be against DeForest. And that'll back them up, likely holding. So we'll get DeForest will get another attempt after the interception on the last drive. And they'll take the ball from their own 20-yard line with 5 minutes and 37 seconds left in the first quarter. So the Norski set up. Trey Schroeder with the handoff. And that'll be Alex Andres who takes it. And that'll be a gain of about 9. Brought down by Mason Folkers.
Daniel James on the stop.
So second and 1, DeForest ready to go.
Second and 1.
Schroeder from the shotgun. Make the handoff again, Enders around the end. He's got some blocks, he's got some room. That would be a big first down. Works his way over into Crusader territory.
Phelan on the stop.
Phelan again making the stop, but not before a gain of about 29 yards or so. Big play there. So DeForest sets up here in the Crusader 49. Schroeder with the shotgun. This time, he'll pass it off to Gabe Finley. Finley goes off tackle, gets about 3.
Brought down by Connor Gravens.
He was brought down by Connor Gravens on the play.
Game 3 on the play, second and 7.
So they'll look at 2nd and 7. Since the interception, DeForest has really stuck to the run game for the most part. But at some point, you would expect to see, in a favorable down and distance situation, another pass attempt. This time, they'll go to Enders. He's got a big hole and blocks downfield. He'll get brought down at about the 31-yard line. Marcus Thielen again on the play.
Down to the 31-yard line.
And truthfully, you got to ask, at this point, the Crusaders owe a huge portion of their plays to Marcus Thielen. This guy is everywhere, offensively, defensively. He punts the ball for them. He is truly a multi-talented guy. Schroeder, the handoff, off tackle, more room, stiff arm, and that'll get the first down. Gabe Finley with a strong carry after some solid blocking, and this run game is working for the Norskies.
To the 11-yard line.
So DeForest is down to the 11-yard line, 1st and 10, with 3 minutes and 24 seconds to go in this scoreless first quarter. Schroeder's going to hand it off. Finley with the carry, strong carries. He breaks a couple tackles, gets to about the 1-yard line. And there is no answer for this off-tackle run game right now. DeForest marching down the field with ease. And now it's a 1st and goal situation. Just about 1.5 yards to go.
Nine on the play.
Finley is credited with a 9-yard run. And it looks like timeout's called. official timeout there. Resumes play quickly. Handoff to Enders, and he's in. Touchdown DeForest.
Touchdown Norsky.
And that run game marched all the way down the field. There is no answer for that on the Crusader side of the ball. They were getting beat at the line of scrimmage there. So 6-0. And Bennett Girton will be on to attempt the extra point. The home crowd excited tonight. And it looks like they'll call a fake. Or maybe it was a muffed snap there. Broken play, but no good nonetheless. So we'll start with a 6-0 score. 3:09 left in the first quarter. But as I was saying, if you are a member of DeForest High School, you are attired in a Hawaiian or tropical shirt this evening. The whole student section is packed, as well as the rest of the bleachers. There is actually a remarkable turnout for this game. And one of the really awesome things, if you've never been to a DeForest area high school football game, I recommend you make plans to do so soon. It is a beautiful facility, state of the art, and it better be with a team that's this competitive year in and year out. So, with a lead, 6-0, DeForest is going to kick off. Now, the Crusaders shown some flashes on offense, but it's mostly from athleticism to this point. Love to see something from their offense, shows that they're in control, that they're making the right plays, that they've got a good game plan together, but that's always tough in the first quarter. Sometimes that game plan hasn't emerged. This game, football, is played so much faster at the game level than it is in practice. Nothing can really simulate it, especially if you're young out there for your first time. So we're about to get started. After the touchdown run from Enders, putting DeForest up 6-0. Bennett Girton with the kick. Back deep is Jackson Trudgeon. He'll grab the ball, he'll make a couple of moves, and he'll bring it out to about the 23-yard line. Trey Warren with the tackle. A defensive star here. I think it'd be... So we're going to get started at the 23-yard line here. But something that I think is apparent here is the size and athleticism of DeForest on the front four. It becomes really imposing if you look closely as they line up here. These are some big, fast, strong guys. So right now, we got Dylan Walton takes the snap, makes a pass, nearly picked off there by Devin McGlee. Broken up there, but there's a flag on the play.
Intended for
Dane Newton. And we'll wait for the call on that. It'll be illegal motion against Edgewood. So another offensive miscue here early on, resulting in a penalty. So after a relatively, what looked like a good setup and a great, great pass, called back on a penalty, and that'll set them back again. And that's not somewhere you want to be when this pass rush is all over you. Can't let your game become one-dimensional if you're the Crusaders right here. That being said, if you're DeForest, this is exactly the situation you want to be. And what just occurred out there on the wings is the kind of defensive situation that they're looking for. Some confusion here up front for the Crusaders. We'll swap things around. Again, Dylan Walton will take the snap here. Feeling out to the left. Split wide. This time, it'll be a keeper. He'll roll out. Throw over the top for Thielen. And it's a goal! He dropped it. He had it in his hands. And unfortunately, couldn't come up with the grab. but a great pass and throw. There is some moves happening here in the offensive backfield. There's a pass option type thing that's keeping everyone, including myself, on their toes. You're not really sure exactly where they're going to go with the play. Good handoffs, good play action. And that time it allowed Thielen to get behind the defense. And if he was able to grab it, that would have been a big play. Instead, it'll be second and 13 for the Crusaders. Pass, pressure, quarterback hit, and that'll be an interception there. Ball by Trace Grundle. He's got room to run. He'll work to the outside, brought down at the Crusaders' 4-yard line. But a brilliant interception and run by Trace Grundle. And that, you owe more credit, honestly, to the defensive line there, getting pressure, putting a hit on the quarterback, number 22, Dylan Walton. The ball goes sailing in the air, and that's an easy play to make. So that really sets up DeForest here to capitalize as they have the ball on the 4-yard line, first and goal. 2 minutes and 26 seconds left in the first quarter, and that'll be a timeout, Edgewood. So the defensive pressure that DeForest is applying early, already paying dividends in terms of turnovers, and we can hope to see, you know, a lot more of these guys out in the future. These are big, strong players and a lot of experience too. So as we mentioned earlier, DeForest coming off of a second place finish last season, playing a hard-fought game, providing Wanakee with their first two trails of the whole entire season. Up until that second-round WIA Division II playoff game, there was absolutely no quarter in which Wanakee trailed, except for when they played DeForest in that game. So clearly, some great coaching, some great athletes, and it becomes really apparent when you're here at the stadium, a great program. Edgewood looking for the goal line stop. The handoff to Enders, and again, he's got his second rushing touchdown. Wow. Untouched there. A huge hole opened up for him, and that'll make it 12-0 DeForest. But Enders making an early case for himself here in the beginning of this season as being the number one back. Really strong goal line type runs. And when you've got him, and you've got Finley, you've got a good running attack. The offensive line leading it, no problem. This extra point goes a little bit wide right. So 0-2 on the extra points, but at this point, the offense is looking strong. Edgewood is gonna have to figure out an answer to that run game. And they're going to have to try and win this battle up front. And I think that's really what it comes down to. But still, again, early on, as we only have 2 minutes, 22 seconds left in the first quarter, it's going to fall on some defensive and offensive adjustments here to account for some of this playmaking that's happening on the DeForest side of things. You've heard his name quite a bit tonight when we call Marcus Thielen's number. He is all over the field, offensively, defensively. Same with Ben Newton. Juniors and seniors, respectively, playing a little bit here and a little bit there, all over the field. Back to receive the kick, Jackson Trudgeon. And again, with the kick, Bennett Gurton. Jackson Trudgeon, hoping to provide a spark. And the kick, Trudgeon under it. And the return, stopped immediately by a gang of DeForest players. Jack Riesling on the lead. And so Edgewood will take over at their 25-yard line. First and 10. A score here would be absolutely crucial. So they're going to stick with Walton in the backfield. Taking the shotgun snap. Fake handoff, play action, screen, and it'll go for a couple of yards. Daniel James on the reception made a couple of players miss. So that'll be second and 5. But nice offensive play there. Gain of 4. So Walton. Looking at 2nd and 5. The snap. Handoff this time. And it'll be brought down in the backfield.
Andrew Stigel
with the carry.
Brought down by Edwin Erickson.
Edwin Erickson with the stop. So on the play, it looks like about a loss of 2. Third and seven. One minute and 34 seconds left in this quarter. Snap. More play action. And Walton will keep it around the ends. Stopped just short after a QB keeper. Adam Zapiniak on the stop. And Edgewood is looking at a 4th and 2. And that'll bring out the Edgewood punt unit. Marlon Sistrunk back to receive the punt. DeForest trailing 12-0 here. With a little bit of time left. The punt, low, and Sistrunk will let it go.
Punt rolls out of bounds. At the 37-yard line.
So the 37-yard line is where the Norskies will start their next drive with a 12-0 lead here. 40 seconds left in the first quarter. The run game has been unstoppable this far for DeForest. Trey Schroeder out of shotgun with Finley in the backfield. He'll pass, and it's caught. Lane Larson in the flat. He'll make a move upfield for about 2 yards on the 40-yard line. So make that 4 yards. And that'll bring up 2nd and 6.
Two of the play brings up 2nd and 8.
Schroeder, handoff, Enders. And he'll get a first down, running it up the gut.
The ball carrier.
Enders having a great game so far. 2 scores. Able to bring the first down there. And that'll wrap up the first quarter, or just about 4.2 seconds left. The referee signaling it should be running clock.
That will take us to the end of the first quarter.
And that'll take us to the end of the quarter. The referees will send it to the quarter with 4 seconds left. They'll run the clock down, and we'll be back in just a moment. You're listening to channel3000.com Red Zone. Welcome back to Channel3000.com High School Football. DeForest taking the ball here to start the second quarter, and it'll be a Schroeder keeper. He's got some moves up the middle, and he's got some big game, strong stiff arm. He's still up, broken a bunch of tackles. What a play. Start the second quarter with attitude. Run it on a QB keeper up the gut, all the way up to the 26-yard line. And a strong first play for the second quarter for the Norskies. First and 10. Schrader out of shotgun, Finley in the backfield. Tight set here for the Norskies. The snap, play action, pass over to the side. That's Logan Bierman. Good enough for a first down. Daniel James with the wrap. So outside of that first series, the Norskies are rolling. This offense looks like it's in midseason form. And maybe it's not for them, but it looks really strong. Schrader, man in motion. That's Larson. He'll hand it off on the end around. Runs into his own man, but he's still on his feet. He's still stumbling and bumbling, and he works his way into the end zone. A great, great run by Lane Larson. End around touchdown. Keeping on the ground is working, but there's a flag on the play. Holding. So that'll get called back. But certainly a wonderful run. Two runs in a row. You've got, obviously, that pass in the middle. But you start out with Schrader running hard up the middle, making a great play, getting it out to the 26. That awesome pass play out to the side. But then Lane Larson, the end around, breaking tackles, refusing to go down. So after that, we're going to be first and 17 here. Norskies setting up. Edgewood showing blitz. They send him. Ender's up the gut. He'll get a couple. Brought down. They ran right at that blitzing action and were able to just push right past it.
Braden's on stop. And for the play, second and 13.
So second and 13. Schrader and shotgun. He'll work out right. Plants, throws across his body to Larson in the back of the end zone. Touchdown, Larson.
Hey, Schrader.
A great play by Schrader. Wonderful back shoulder throw. That fade perfectly executed. And that is the third touchdown of the game for the DeForest Norskies. 18 to nothing. Now, one thing that hasn't been going quite as smoothly as the other elements of the game has been this extra point. And it's tricky to do, but it would be, you know, it's points on the board. So Bennett Girton gets ready to kick again. And he puts it through. So with 10:28 remaining in the first half, DeForest has jumped out to a sustainable lead here, 19 to nothing. And Edgewood's going to have to put something on the board soon here. They don't want to fall too far behind the home team. But again, what they're going to do that is they're going to have to win the battle up front. There is a Norski in the backfield on every single play. And you can't run your offense. You can't get into a rhythm, which is all you're really trying to do when you're here in this early part of the game. Early part of the season, for that matter. So now back to receive. The Elijah Gray and Jackson Trudgeon. Gerton will again be the kicker here. A crucial, crucial drive for the Crusaders.
Gerton today the kicking. Trudgeon and James back deep for Edgewood.
The boots, nice and deep. James will get under it. Cutting across the field, makes a dart, brought down by Marlon Sisternick.
Marlon Sisternick on the stop.
That'll bring it to about the 25-yard line. So first and 10 at their own 25, and Edgewood has to do something here. The crowd really getting into it. The student section. Seems like people are still coming into this stadium, if that feels possible. All right. Walton set. He's got two backs. And he'll hand off to Elijah Gray, who will sweep, but he'll be brought down for a loss.
Trey Warren
with the play. Heard his name a couple of times tonight. So the Crusaders still looking for a hole in this defense. Haven't found it on the outside over there by Trey Warren. They're facing a long, long play here. Second and 13 to go. Gray in the backfield with Walton. Walton's got two out right, one left. Take the snap. Pass underneath. And that'll be a run of a couple of yards. Jackson Trudgeon with the play.
Cisco there defensively for DeForest.
And that's something that they haven't run so far. And it's nice to see them try that underneath route. And it was pretty effective. If you've got these defensive backs, you don't have time to wait for anything deep. These defensive backs are helping out with the run game, and forget about it with the defensive line here with DeForest. And they found something that looks promising there. See if they go to that short pass game some more on third and one. Gray in the backfield, out of shotgun. And it'll be a keeper for Walton. He'll work forward, brought down by a host of DeForest players.
First and 10, Edgewood.
First and 10. Edwin Erickson at the bottom of that pile.
50 raffle tickets to halftime, through halftime, so make sure you get those. Brody's Roar, 50-50 tonight. A wingspan of those.
So 8:30 left, 19-0 the score here in the second quarter. The ball on the 37. And we've got a first and 10. Walton trying to hurry his offense up. Getting his men set. Takes the snap. Pressure from the backside. He's hit as he throws, but that's a complete for a touch, or for a first down, pardon me, and that's going to be Thielen, Marcus Thielen. So despite the pressure and despite the hard hit on Walton, this Crusaders offense looks like it's making some moves here. Walton setting up. From a shotgun formation. The snap, the sweep, pressure immediately brought down by Edwin Erickson. A great play. Gray, the ball carrier, looking to get that edge, and again, it is not there. Swallowed up almost immediately upon receiving the ball. So a loss of about 5, second and 15. And the Crusaders are going to have to find an answer for that defensive line. They're set up. DeForest with the 4-3. Thielen rocks back through the hands of Trace Grundle. Almost intercepted. Intended for Marcus Thielen, but a little bit overthrown there. And that's going to bring up a 3rd and 15. So a situation, again, that Walton and this team does not want to be in. They're going to have to face the full brunt of that defensive pass rush. Cole Yoakum, Trey Warren, Edwin Erickson have been all over the ball carriers tonight. Walton, he drops back. Pressure brought down by Warren.
And Martin sacked on the play. Trey Warren with the sack.
And again, the DeForest pass rush breaks up the play before it can even start. So 4th and 20, and the Crusaders will punt. Ben Newton back there to do that for them. Back to receive for DeForest, Marlon Sisdrunk. Newton with the punt. It's low, line drive. Sisdrunk gets it on a bounce. He'll work to the left, brought down by Daniel James.
Brought down the play by Daniel James.
So DeForest will take over at their 39-yard line. They've got 5 minutes and 53 seconds left in this half. The score at the moment, 19 to nothing. Enders ran into, and then a great completion from Schroeder Lane Larson on a fade route of the back of the end zone. And an extra point to make it 19 to nothing. Schrader to Finley. The draw. He'll be met at the line of scrimmage. Pushes for about a yard or two. And that'll bring up 2nd down. Defense might be able to catch up a little bit to that running game, but certainly in the first quarter, it was tough to stop. Schrader in the backfield. With the fake handoff, he'll pitch it to the outside to Enders, who will work the edge, lower his shoulder, get pushed out of bounds, but not before getting a 1st down for the Norskies. That was a big run for Enders.
13
on the play. And the run game again, really tough to stop. They're able to work it around the edges and up the gut. And if you're savvy on that, they've shown that they can throw it over your head. It's a really well-balanced attack that you're seeing. Larson in motion. They'll fake that end around they ran earlier. Schroeder around the edge. He'll cut up field.
Schrader and the keeper.
Brought down by Connor Grabness.
Brought down by Gravens. Gain of 6 on the play. 2nd and 4.
Gain of 6. 2nd and 4. And I think a big difference here between these two teams right now is what kind of down and distance situations they put themselves in. And DeForest has done a good job of staying ahead of the chains. Schrader hands off to Finley. Short run.
Ravens on stop.
Brought down by Ravens again.
And 3 on the play brings up 3rd and 1.
3rd and 1 after the gain of 3. And the Huskies, the Northies will have to make a conversion here. They haven't been forced into this situation like I was talking about earlier very often tonight. They've stayed ahead of the chains. Their offense has been moving. Here they'll have to get a conversion. The snap is low, and there's flags on the play. Or I guess they'll call it a dead ball. Snap was too low. So the ball is downed. It'll be a fourth and five. And that'll bring out the Norskies putt unit. So after that kind of muffed long snap, the opportunity has evaded the Norskies, and they'll punt it away. Back to receive is Jackson Trudgeon. Fake punt, reverse to Enders, and he's got room, daylight, at the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Norskies!
Touchdown, Norskies!
Maybe we should have saw it coming. It seemed like they were determined to get that first down, and instead they called not only a fake punt, but a fake punt reverse. Alexander then runs the ball all the way down the field. He was so wide open, and in a track meet, he had no problem. So that'll make the score 25-0 DeForest. And Bennett Gurton back to kick the extra point. And it is through. So in the second quarter, Bennett Gurton's been perfect. And DeForest has looked strong. Now it's really up to Edgewood. They're going into the half here. DeForest kicked the ball off. So they'll be receiving in the second half. You've got to put something on the scoreboard now. You don't want to go into halftime with your heads down, hoping to make a miracle happen in this second half. You don't want to let DeForest win the game now. When you're the visiting team, that's where you got to dig deep, and that's where you got to make those plays. So we'll see if they can get something going. We talked about, first of all, you've got to stop this defensive front for DeForest. Edwin Erickson, Trey Warren, and Cole Yoakum have been all over every single play. There's always someone in the backfield. So Gurton will get set up here. Edwin Erickson, who's been making his name known tonight, was actually first team all-conference honors last year. So he's no stranger to accolades. Lane Larson, who's also made his name known tonight with the end around, the touchdown grab earlier at the beginning of the second quarter. He was second team all-conference on offense. So Benny Gurton with the boot. It's low and it's left, and that'll be a penalty. So, went off the side of his foot there a little bit. And that's okay. When you've got a lead like that, you can. He shrugs it off as he walks off the field. It's one of those days. Sometimes when you're a kicker, you know, you've got to have that next play mentality. And today, there's been some early successes for him, and there's been some early trials. But Benny Gurton seems to have a really solid, strong leg. And that's really what you're looking for when you're in this high school thing. He can practice. By the end of the season, he can be solid. But it becomes a matter of confidence and a matter of getting the reps in these game situations. You know, you can't simulate the kind of pressure that you're on as a kicker, even in non-pressure situations. The stadium gets a little quiet. Everyone's watching. So the Crusaders taking the ball over at their own 35-yard line. They've got 3 minutes and 32 seconds to chip away at this 26-0 deficit left in this half. So Walton out of the shotgun. More pressure. Hit as he throws. And that'll be incomplete. Intended for Elijah Gray. more contact again. And Warner certainly feeling the contact. That becomes tough. This becomes a mental toughness game. There's a constant barrage of Norskis getting into the backfield. So Walton, he's got second and 10. Shotgun snap. Gray in motion. And Walton, working out on a bootleg, throws it a little low for Gray. And so that'll bring up third and 10.
So Yoko with the pressure. Third and 10.
The crowd really getting into things here. Obviously, you got to like what you see when you've got a big season ahead of you, like DeForest does. High expectations. One of the better teams they've had in a while. Maybe this is the year where they can dethrone Wanakee. Came exceptionally close last year. And that's really the talk of the Badger North Conference so far. So Walton. From shotgun. Timeout called, Edgewood. So they've got one left here in the first half. And they'll have to think it over. Third and long. This becomes a really crucial play. We were talking about earlier, momentum-wise, you have to send your team into the locker room with something. Especially if you're going to go and ask that defense to try and stop this Norskies offense, which is just rolling at the moment. DeForest area has been solid from everything after the first possession, where they threw that quick interception. They've been moving the ball almost at will. It looks crisp and clean. So really nothing game plan wise that Edgewood isn't doing. It's more just a matter of the execution has been nonstop from the DeForest side of the ball. And when that's happening, it's hard to get traction, to get momentum. And offensively, they have to get some blocks. If Walton's going to be able to look downfield, he's got to have more than 2 seconds. And when you start to get hit a couple of times, you know, whether Walton will admit it or not, he's looking for that pressure. He's feeling that pressure, and it's getting in the way of what he's trying to do, move his ball down, move his team down the field. So Walton, empty backfield. Long toss to Gray. He brings it down. Complete at the 50-yard line. Gray with a ninth grab there. Again, 3 minutes and 15 seconds remain in the half. 26 to nothing to score. And that's first and 10 Edgewood. Now's the time where they're looking to use that momentum, create some positive plays, build on that success they just had. Some good protection there from the line. So Walton hands it to Gray, and he's brought down immediately. The ball gets out, and it's recovered by DeForest, but it will be ruled down. Edgewood will keep the ball, albeit they will be moved backwards quite a bit. Loss of 9, second and 19. Ball came out there at the end. The Norskies all over it. That play, however, credited to Alonzo Blevins. So the Crusaders, with just over 2 minutes, second and long. Walton dropping back, has pressure, steps up, and he'll complete the catch underneath to Marcus Thielen. Good on Marcus Thielen, getting open in that broken play, getting it close to the original down marker. Third and 11. So again, a long yardage situation on third down. We're going to take some offensive creativity here, because there's going to be some pressure. You can almost bet on it. So Walton settles in. He'll take the snap. He rolls out. Pressure almost immediately from Trey Warren, who comes from the backside. Walton had just enough time to tuck that ball in. So a huge, huge sack with just under a minute to play. And it's going to be fourth and long. Looks like time was called there for Edgewood to gather their thoughts after a pretty devastating turn of events. That was the drive. That was the one that you wanted to get it going on. You had that nice completion to Gray for the first down. Then you found Thielen. You were making some progress. And again, the pressure has been really tough to do anything about. So 54 seconds left. You can't imagine that they're looking to punt the ball, especially after calling the timeout here. The Norskies defensive unit taking the field. You know, you wonder what might be up their sleeve here in terms of, you know, you've got to make big yardage. You got to be looking downfield. There's no point in doing something underneath. So we'll see how they buy themselves that time. Currently, they've got the punt unit out there, which I find surprising. Ben Newton will be punting it.
Newton to do the punting.
Sistrunk back for DeForest. And they do punt it away. Best punt of the night for the Crusaders. Sistrunk bobbles it. He picks it up. He's working out to the right. He makes a move, makes a guy miss.
Marlon
Sistrunk with a nice return. Brings it out to about the 37-yard line.
First down!
So the Norskies, with a 26-0 lead, have about 48 seconds left in the first half to make something happen. We'll see how they elect to use this time. They've got a spread formation. Schrader looking to pass. Underneath to Larson.
Pass is complete to Lane Larson.
He'll be brought down by
Dylan Walton, defensively for
Dylan Walton, the quarterback there. Getting a chance to return the favor. He's taking a lot of contact here early on. DeForest will call a timeout. 35 seconds left in the half. Welcome back to Channel3000.com High School Football. I'm Ole Yeager, and we're getting started here. We've got about 40 seconds left in the first half. Schrader rolls out, gets it to Larson. Larson finds the out of bounds, but not before getting the first down.
Run out of bounds by Dylan Walton.
The ball on the 49-yard line, and that's a first and 10, 34 seconds, and they're trying to score here. They're using the clock well. They've got one timeout to work with. Schrader rolling out. Got a little pressure. He's got Bryce Jacobson wide open, incomplete. A little high.
Second and 10.
But if he was able to bring that in somehow, he was wide open. He had daylight.
We have one of the camper raffle tickets.
So second and 10, 27 seconds left. You got to think they're looking at Lane Larson right here. He's got that downfield speed. He's shown he's got good hands. Being a senior, he's got that leadership. And that's just what they do. They go downfield to Larson. and he just misses on a diving catch attempt. Went right through his fingers, close to the 10-yard line. But a brilliant, brilliant play call there. Larson kind of streaking up the middle, gets inside of his defender, works towards the middle, and uses his speed from there. It was a great route run, and he was reliably open. You could tell right off of the snap there that that's where Schroeder was going. So, 19 seconds left, 3rd and 10. DeForest has trips left, and Schroeder will roll left. Looking downfield, a little bit of pressure from behind. He'll try and go underneath, and it's caught to Larson, who toe-tapped on the sideline there to bring it in. 10 seconds left, 4th down. And so it pretty much just kind of comes down to this play. What are they going to do here? They've got the offensive unit out there.
Bring up 4th and 3.
So now the lineup trips right. 10 seconds for Schroeder. Take the snap. He'll keep it. He works right. He's got the first down, trying to make an edge. He's tripped up by Ben Newton and finished off by Alex Walton over there. So, a good keeper, and it looks like DeForest called timeout. 3 seconds left. So this is the last play of the first half. And if DeForest is able to score here, they can make it at least 32-0 and really set themselves up. Now, they do get the ball to start the second half. And that's where you're really starting to see the pressure be put on the Crusaders. So what they're going to do, what they need to do here, if you're the Crusaders, get a stop here. Put yourself in position to keep it 26-0. 26-0 is a much more manageable score. And it gives you a little bit of a morale boost going in. Stop this offense. You were able to do it in the first drive. So that's what they're if I'm the coach, that's what I'm saying to them in this huddle. Now, if you're DeForest, you just say, go get them, boys. Keep doing what you're doing. Keep making those plays. Keep driving the ball down the field. Keep executing. And that's likely what they'll do. So 3 seconds left, 26-0 here. The first half winding down. DeForest trying to add on to their score. Schroeder will start in shotgun. Larson split out right. He drops back. He's looking at Larson. Over the top. It'll be a battle. Thielen able to knock it away. So that'll take us to the half. DeForest is up 26-0. Thank you so much for listening. We'll be back in just a few moments with Channel3000.com High School Football.
DHS dance team. Tonight is youth football night. We'd like to take this time to recognize all of our future Norskies. Starting with the eighth graders, with head coach Mike Loveland, with assistants Bill Harmon, Kevin Weigel, and Mike Loveland as the grade director. The eighth graders. The seventh graders, with head coach Ron Jacobson and assistants Jason Larson, Jason Zander, Doug Eberhardt, and Reggie Patterson. The sixth graders, with head coach Nate Ladwig, with assistants Tim Dobbs, Christine Matthews, Brad Ellingson, Jamie Dringa, Gavin Bovary. The fifth graders, with head coach Nick Kemp, with assistants Casey Feiner, James Pertzborn, Ryan Brown, and Connor Drew. The fourth graders, with head coach Ryan Shaw, with assistants Michael Allen, Justin Jacobs, Justin Megley, and Steve Tanner. How about a big round of applause to all of our future Norskies on DeForest Youth Football Night.
Welcome back to Channel3000.com Red Zone Football. I'm Ole Yeager, and we're about ready to get started in the second half of this season opener between the DeForest Area High School Norskies and the Edgewood Crusaders. The kick is back. And to receive it, be number 11, Adam Sapeniak.
Adam Sapeniak on the return.
Nice return there.
Well,
he'll bring the ball out to about the 25-yard line. And that'll be first and 10. The DeForest offense was moving at will in the first half. Put up a score of 26-0 on the visitors. Schroeder in shotgun. He'll hand off to Finley. Finley makes a couple of moves, gets to the outside. He's got room, one man to beat, and he's brought down. Ben Newton there. The safety made that play. Otherwise, Finley had daylight and likely another score. So 18 on the play, first and 10. And that's that running attack that really separated the two teams in the first half. At the trenches, you know, DeForest is winning the one-on-one battles. Schrader and shotgun. He'll hand off to Ender. Around the end, he's got blockers. He's got room. He makes a cutback to the inside. He's brought down. Connor Graben's on the stop. And the chains are moving. That'll bring it down to the opponent's 35-yard line. Another first and 10.
At the 35-yard line, first down.
And DeForest keeps on moving. Schroeder. Screen to Larson. Larson breaks a tackle. Gets across the 30. Larson proving to be a reliable target this evening. Outside of receiving the first receiving touchdown of the game, he's also made some nice plays in the interim and had some really good looks down the field. Second and 4. Schrader, the draw to Finley. He busts up the middle. And he's got a big gain for a first down and then some. Getting within the Crusaders 15. So first and 10 again. In just under 2 minutes, DeForest has moved down the field. And they are threatening again. 26-0. Currently with DeForest on top. They send Larson in motion. A little jumbling in the backfield. Handoff to Finley.
Finley, the ball carrier.
Brought down by a couple Crusaders. Led by Jackson Trudgeon. So second and seven. And this is the time where Mike Minnick is going to settle his offense into a nice deliberate pace. Chew up the clock and don't give the Crusaders multiple opportunities to get back in this game. Schrader, another draw to Finley. He's moving his feet. And the ball comes out. And there is a pile down there. And we'll have to see where this one ended up. But the ball came out. Finley drove towards the goal line. Was stopped just short of the goal line. He's going to be ruled down. So it's going to be first and goal.
First and goal.
And a flinch on the offensive line. False start. That's Cody Hardig. So that'll move DeForest back a few yards. 5 yards to be exact there. Not many penalties that you've seen in this game, and typically that's something that you can expect in a first game of the season. But so far the play's been relatively clean. So the handoff to Finley again. He'll try and finish his work. He's stopped just short. A wonderful driving tackle made by Daniel James. He's able to get under that pad level of Finley, drive him back, and save the touchdown. So second and one. DeForest again threatening. 8 minutes, 24 seconds left in the third quarter. Schrader keeps it, makes it bounce to the outside, and he walks it into the end zone. So another DeForest touchdown. 32-0 is the score. And this team has started this season with a statement game. They're saying, Badger North Conference, look out. So we've got a new place kicker here for the second half. Bennett Girton had two extra points in the first half. This one, yes, Jagger Loken.
Underscore with a 12 remaining in the third quarter.
So 33-0.
Edgewood zero
after about 4 minutes of play. So getting ready to kick off here. And now this is really becoming a situation. Edgewood has got to stop the bleeding. And it's going to start with offense. So far, they really haven't been able to put a drive together. Before the second half, or the first half ended, they were able to record consecutive first downs for the first time in the game. So hopefully they can build on that. That can be their win here. But it kind of does feel like the air has been drawn out of that Edgewood sideline right now. And they need a spark to get back in this game. And they're going to rely on their return men to do it for this play. Stepping back for the Crusaders, Jackson Trudgeon and Elijah Gray. Bennett Girton be using his big leg here. So 8 minutes and 12 seconds to play. DeForest kicks the ball off, and again, it goes out of bounds. So that's two kickoffs today for Girton that have gone awry, and a couple of extra points in the first half. And that's something that'll come. It's always tricky, you know, especially when you've got position players, not specialists out there at this level. who, you know, they've got other responsibilities, they've got other things to practice, and, you know, sometimes the extra point can be a little bit of an afterthought. But it is truly different. You can make, 20, 30 in a row in practice, but when you got this big DeForest crowd here, the DeForest students screaming from the sidelines, it makes it tough to make those consistently. So Walton for the Crusaders will set up in shotgun here, trying to get something going for his offense. Currently, the Crusaders trail 33-0 with 8:12 left in the third quarter. Walton's going to keep it. And he faces pressure from Cole Yoakum, forced to throw the ball away, incomplete.
Second and 10, Edgewood.
So second and 10, Edgewood. And again, pressure. Walton didn't have time to let the play develop. He's forced to get rid of it. Otherwise, he'd take the sack. So they'll look to get something going here. They'll send Thielen, split out white, left. James in the backfield. Handoff. He'll get around the end, get a few yards, pushed out of bounds. Gain of about four.
Pushed out of bounds by Chet Reese.
Correction. Gain of three on the play. It'll be third and 7 here.
Check at third and 7.
Walton. He's got another third and long situation. He's going to have to watch out for that pressure up front. The snap. He steps back, pressure again, gets it out to Gray, who's up the sidelines, lowers his shoulder, and he's going to pick up a first down. Nice play by Gray. Again, a lot of pressure there for Walton. Good job having pocket awareness, getting rid of the ball.
First and
10, Edgewood. 7 minutes and 53 seconds left in the third quarter. Walton sets up. He has Gray in the backfield. A split back. And it'll be a keeper. Walton out to the sidelines. It'll be a loss of about two.
Dylan Walton on the keeper.
And tried that counter play that time. They sent the split back in motion. Fake to Gray in that play action and tried to find some space for Walton. But no room.
Loss of two on the play, second and 12.
So second and 12. The defense for DeForest has been strong tonight. And the fans are loving it. Dylan Walton drops back. Long toss. He's got Gray. Gray caught the ball. Was he inbounds? And it's ruled a catch. A long completion for Dylan Walton.
Caught by Daniel James.
An excellent down the field play. Elijah Gray underneath it.
24-yard line, first and 10, Edgewood.
So first and 10, Edgewood. That was their first play, first chunk play of the game. And so they've clearly made some adjustments to this passing game in the halftime adjustment period. And they're taking some shots down the field. Walton's getting rid of the ball quicker. And they're running some misdirection. So Walton's got first and 10. He drops back. Pass underneath to Gray, and he is smothered by the linebacker. That's Jet Reese on the play. So incomplete, second and 10. Gray was there, but excellent coverage by Reese. All over it. Hard, clean hit. Knocks the ball out. Incomplete. So another really solid defensive play. And at this point, it's really looking like DeForest is in midseason form. You know, they haven't dropped coverage. They're not experiencing any penalties outside of that, you know, the kicking issues and that one false start. It's been a pretty clean game. There's some NFL teams that can't get it together like this for week one. So Walton, he's got two backs in the backfield. He'll hand off to Gray. Doesn't have a lot of room. And there's a flag on the play. The ball looks like it came out, but there'll be ruled dead ball. Gray had no room trying to find an edge. Cole Yoakum providing an excellent contain out there.
Holding on Edgewood.
And it's a holding call. So that'll back him up 10 yards. It'll be second and very long for Edgewood. And it's kind of like a one step forward, two steps back kind of afternoon for these guys.
10 yards to the spot of the ball, brings up second.
Walton's got four receivers. He's settling in. Second and 24. Drops back. Pressure immediately. Trey Warren in for the sack.
Trey Warren.
Beat his man off the ball. Gets right to the quarterback. Makes an excellent play. And these two defensive ends are making it really tough. Between Cole Yoakum, Trey Warren, there's nowhere to go on the outside. When you drop back to pass, you're getting stuck in that, in kind of that, you know, collapsing pocket. And those linebackers are making it impossible to step up. So on any given play, there really isn't anywhere to go for these ball carriers for the Crusaders. Walton's got third and 28. And timeout is called for the Crusaders. Excuse me, correct that. That was a delay of game. The play clock was winding down. It looked like there was some confusion on the play call. And another negative tack for the Crusaders. They're looking at third and 33.
5 yard penalty. Third and 33.
So we talked about staying out of third and longs in the second half. This is the kind of situation you were hoping to avoid. Again, that pass rush comes up. Dalton able to step up, and he's hit hard again by Reese. Reese filled that gap. He tracked it perfectly. So he's there up the middle. And that pass rush is just getting after the quarterback. So now we've got a fourth and long situation. Walton only able to gain up a few yards. Fourth and 29. 5 minutes and 58 seconds left in the third quarter. 33 to nothing to DeForest. So the punt unit on for the Crusaders. Back to return is Sistrunk. He muffs it and is picked up by Edgewood. Was in on the play. There's a dog pile. Edgewood signaling it's theirs. And it is. So a muffed punt gives Edgewood the ball on their 10-yard line of DeForest. You talk about it, when you're down in a game, and the offense and the defense is struggling in the trenches, one way that you can get some momentum, special teams. And that's just what Edgewood was able to do. Now let's see if they can capitalize on this short yard situation. It's first and goal, the closest they've been all day. Outside of a couple of chunk plays, they haven't been able to get a consistent drive going. So Walton's got Thielen out left. And Newton. Gray in the backfield. He rolls out, throws across his body, and it is picked off by number 23, Devin Magle. an excellent interception. Hard-fought battle, goes up, grabs that ball, attacks the ball in the air at its highest point, and comes away with the interception. Nice physical defense to turn that situation around. And just when the Crusaders had an opportunity, the defense for DeForest is able to take it away. So extremely disappointing for the Crusaders, as they will now be handing the ball off to DeForest on their own 10-yard line. The difference here, DeForest has had no trouble driving the ball. So score 33-0 DeForest, 5:25 left in the third. That handoff, up the gut, Mason Kirchberg. He's able to get a couple of yards there. Second and one. So solid running again. One in the trenches up there. Alex Schrader, he's got two backs again. And he's going to hand it off. Kirchberg again, he'll get the first down and then some. Works up to just short of the 35. They'll spot it at the 33. First and 10. Certainly a deliberate pace for DeForest. They're in no rush. Schrader to Finley. He'll keep it. Yard, but a gain of 9 yards. Running a little bit of that run pass option there. They were rolling out. He had Finley. You know, he elected to keep it. He had so many options there. And honestly, you could have made that play in a couple of ways off of that setup. Really nice play call there. Schrader, out of shotgun. He's got two backs. Handoff. Fake play action and a bullet pass to Logan Bierman. That'll be a good for a first down. Brought down by Joe Hartley. A gain of 14. And with just 4 minutes left in the third quarter, that's another first down. DeForest driving here. Just three plays. They've been able to get themselves from their own 10-yard line out into enemy territory. Schrader tosses it deep. A little bit overthrown for Logan Bierman. But he had a good look. Bierman had just beaten his defender, so it was a matter of connecting on that pass. Could have done some damage deep. So don't let those runs out of the... You know, at the beginning of this drive, fool you. They're still looking deep, and they're still looking for those passes. You got to be honest. You can't stack the box and ignore Logan Larson, for instance, who right now is split out left. Schrader hands it off. Finley going to the weak side. He's got blockers, and he's got room, and he'll drive across the 25. A nice run by Finley. A flag on the play. A little bit late, I might add. And we'll have to hear what this looks like. The referees discussing exactly what went down. It looked like something after the play that happened somewhere around the 25-yard line. Unsportsmanlike conduct on Edgewood. So frustration possibly setting in. The score right now is 33-0 with 3 minutes and 25 seconds left in the third quarter. And DeForest shows no signs of slowing the scoring down.
That penalty is half the distance to the goal line from the 12-yard line. First down.
So after the penalty is tacked down, which is half the distance to the goal line, it's going to be a first and 10 DeForest from the 12-yard line. Well, that'll be a timeout. We'll be back in just a moment. You're listening to High School Football on Channel 3000. Welcome back to Channel3000.com, where you're watching high school football. I'm Ole Yeager, and DeForest High School has the ball on the 12-yard line, and then Schrader's going to keep it, and he's going to run it in. So
DeForest comes out of the timeout strong with a QB keeper, and Schrader puts DeForest up 39-0. And again, you give the credit to the ball carrier. Obviously, they do the finishing touches there, but the work is being done by this offensive line just blowing Edgewood off the ball. Schrader was hardly touched till he got to the second level. So you have a lot of confidence sending your quarterback on those designed runs when you know that offensive line can contain the defense. So the extra point is good. Jagerlaken. So the new score, 40-0 with 320 left in the third quarter. Welcome back to Channel3000.com, where we've got high school football on tap for you. DeForest currently on top of Edgewood, 42-0, 320 left to play in the third quarter. Currently, you've got a walloping going on offensively for DeForest. They've been almost unstopped. The kickoff here, off the foot of Benny Gurdon. And Elijah Gray will let it go wisely into the end zone for a touchback.
It rolls into the end zone, touchback.
But up to this point, it's been really tough for Edgewood to get anything going, and for DeForest to, you know, to be halted is going to take something new, something creative. Right now, the offense is running the run game as designed. Very little contact on the running backs, very little penetration or disruption from the defensive line, and that's really where this game is being won. Edgewood taking the field.
On the 21st and 10, Edgewood.
Trying to overcome the 40-point deficit. Starting at their own 20-yard line. Walton over the middle to Thielen, and he is hit hard by Marlon Sistrunk. And Thielen is down. Sistrunk timed that hit perfectly to disrupt the play. And we'll be right back in just a few moments. You're listening to High School Football on Channel3000.com. Welcome back to Channel3000.com High School Football. So the Edgewood Crusaders have the ball 2nd and 10 on their own 20-yard line after the incomplete pass to Thielen. Alex Walton from the shotgun snap. Hands off to Gray. The sweep they've called a couple of times. Another hard hit from Sistrunk again, who is flying around. He is making a lot of plays. The punt returner is had a couple of opportunities to return punts tonight, also making his name known defensively. All over the run, all over the pass, and it's hard to work in his area of the field. Edgewood's going to have to try something other than that sweep to that side. The contain is not going to allow it to turn upfield. So Alex Walton takes a snap, rolls out, flag down, incomplete.
Flag on play.
Pass intended for 23. It's Tyler Foster. First time he's been targeted this evening. Holding Edgewood.
Edgewood is the call.
So another 5 yards, they'll be banked up. And this is tough.
Yeah, penalty will be declined.
I guess the penalty will be declined, bringing up the fourth down, 4th and 8. And that'll bring out the punt unit again. So another drive stalled for the Crusaders by penalties and great defensive performances. The pressure still coming, but this time it was the defensive backfield making their presence known, shutting down these outside runs and short passes. So Newton back to punt. Sistrunk to receive for DeForest. High but short punt. ranging towards the sidelines, didn't quite make it to midfield. So DeForest will take over on the 37-yard line of Edgewood. First and 10, currently 40-0 in favor of DeForest. 56 seconds left to play in the third quarter. Currently on running clock. So this clock is running, counting down now. And it looks like there may be a change at quarterback. But regardless, they hand off to Finley. Bryce Jacobson taking some reps at quarterback here with the lead. Finley gets an 11-yard gain, and he'll grab a first down. So the Norskies still driving, no matter who's in charge. First and 10. Bryce Jacobson, the junior quarterback. Spent a little bit of time at receiver earlier this afternoon. He'll hand off to Finley again, who shakes contact in the backfield, drives forward, and turns it into a positive play.
And that'll take us to the end of the third quarter. After three,
and that will take us to the end of the third quarter. We'll be back in just a few moments. You're listening to High School Football on Channel3000.com. Welcome back to Channel3000.com. We're starting the fourth quarter. DeForest up 40-0. Jacobson as the quarterback, he'll keep it, he'll run, get a first down, and then some, chops his feet, pushed out of bounds around inside the 5-yard line. So a great run. Bryce Jacobson, going to get called back, holding call, flag sneaking on the other side of the field over there. So that'll come back 5 yards. And DeForest will take over from the 29.
Second and 13.
DeForest lining up second and 13. They've got a much tighter set now. Jacobson hands the ball off. Number 20 with his first carry of the night, Mitch Hahn.
It's a blue ticket number two.
And fatigue really beginning to wear on the Edgewood sideline. A lot of substitutions being made here. And it's tough. When you've got this kind of pounded down their throat style of running the ball, it's exhausting if you can't stop it. You know, they're finding different backs, fresh legs to get in there, and the front five are really holding up their holes. So, man in motion. And they'll hand it off again. Draw. Mitch Hahn. Short game. Graben's on the stop.
Once again, a 50-50 raffle ticket. 275-330. That's a blue ticket.
Now, 4th and 7. And they're leaving Jacobson in there to make something happen. Remember, clock winding down, close to 10 minutes left in the game. 40-0 DeForest. Snap. And they'll throw out wide. That's caught. Number 2, Hayden Rawls gets a first down. And the chains keep moving.
Right on the play by Jackson Trudgeon.
Defensive effort there by Jackson Trudgeon on the coverage.
From the 13-yard line first.
So the Norskies with the ball in the 13-yard line trying to add to the score here, already up 40-0. And they're knocking on the door again with their backup quarterback. Jacobson looks poised. He'll hand it off again to Hahn. Hahn working up the middle, stops short. After a gain of about 4 or 5. DeForest tonight has been able to effectively get about 4 to 5 yards on even their shortest carries all game. And that's really tough. It's really hard to get them behind the chains, force them into that third down situation where they have to make a play. Jacobson, Edgewood showing blitz. They'll hand it off to Hahn on the outside. He's close to the first down. And looks like he'll be ruled short.
Done by Sam Still.
Oh, no, they'll give him the first down after a quick measure. I don't know if all the referees were on the same page there. So first and goal on the 3 yard line.
I think against Edward with hands to the face. Puts it two.
So Jacobson with the handoff. Actually, he'll keep it on the play action. Runs into a pile of bodies.
Jacobson on the keeper.
And he'll be stopped short of the touchdown. No gain. So second and two. Actually, second and goal. On the 2 yard line. 7 minutes and 30 seconds left in play. So not only is this drive looking like it's going to end in some type of a score, but it is eating up a considerable amount of clock due to the clock running mercy rule here we have in WIA football. Jacobson. Oh, there's a muffed handoff. It looks like it took Mitch Hahn down. He tripped, so Jacobson took it and ran it in for a touchdown. Took matters into his own hands. 46 to nothing, Norskies, and the score just keeps piling on. And looks like they'll have number 18, Jagerlaken, back to take this place kick. He's been the kicker for the second half. The first half, that duty was fulfilled by Bennett Gerton. Jagerlaken. Remains perfect in 2019, 3 for 3. So we'll step aside for a quick moment, but we'll be back in just a second with Channel3000.com High School Football, where we have DeForest up 47 to nothing with 7:12 left in the fourth. Welcome back to Channel3000.com, where we've got high school football for you today. DeForest on top of Edgewood, 47 to nothing with 7 minutes and 12 seconds left to go in the fourth quarter. Right now, Bennett Gerton setting to kick off. James back, line drive kick, and it'll go out again. So one struggle today has been the ability to place the kickoffs, but the defense has been able to pick up the slack all day long. Currently, Edgewood being shut out here. They've got to get something going. A lot of pressure on quarterback Dylan Walton. Having a hard time completing passes downfield due to excellent coverage by the Norskies. So the options are limited, and the time is running out. At this point, you just want to put something on the board. And, you know, it becomes a building block for the rest of the season. You knew coming in, you're facing DeForest, you're facing the number two finisher in the Badger North Conference last year, only because Wanakee is there as well. And without that, you know, DeForest reigns really supreme, one of the premier programs in the area. So you knew you'd have a challenge. I think you just hope that you'd be able to, you know, move them away from their game plan a little bit more. But such that it is, 47 to nothing, 6 minutes and 30 seconds to play, rolling clock. Dylan Walton has just a few minutes to get his offense going in some capacity. The snap, they'll hand off to Gray. Gray works the edge. Big hit there. Stop made by number 14, Trevor Kanapaki. So a gain of about 6 on that play. Bring up 2nd and 4.
6 on the play. 2nd and 4.
We're about halfway through the fourth quarter. Walton, he's got two receivers out left. He's got time. He unloads. Number five, broken up brilliantly. Was that intercept? No. They're ruling that it was ruled down. Played brilliantly in coverage and almost intercepted by Trevor Kanapaki, but ruled as an incomplete pass. So third and four. That being said, there was a holding penalty against Edgewood. So not only was it incomplete, but they're going to move back. And it's been the story of the day. And it seems as though the game goes on, these types of plays are happening more and more. So a 10-yard penalty. I'm going to get second and 14. Again, behind the chains, they're going to have to make some big plays down the field here. When they looked their most comfortable, they were coming out of the half, and they were running a shorter little offense. Shorter passes, moving the ball downfield. But when you're in these long situations, your hands are tied. Walton, he has pressure. He'll roll out. Looking for Daniel James, incomplete, through the hands. 4 minutes left to play here, third and 13. So the pass was there. James was open. Maybe he led him a bit too much, but that could have been big for Edgewood. One of the few times that one of their receivers, one of the Edgewood receivers, hasn't been draped in a purple jersey. Third and long for Walton. He'll drop back, pressured immediately. It looked to be a design screen, but James tripped and the ball goes incomplete. So they let in that defensive line. They were hoping to, you know, clear the defensive front and get behind them with James in space. Instead, there's some slipping going on, and it's fourth and 13. And again, Ben Newton is back for the Crusaders to punt. New return man, Weisbrod, for DeForest, back to receive the punt. It's up in the air. He'll let it go. Probably a wise decision, as it was kind of a shorter punt. And DeForest will take it on the 31-yard line, winning 47-0 in the fourth quarter with just 2 minutes and 38 seconds of running clock left. And now, if you're DeForest and you're Mike Minnick, it's time to control the clock. Don't turn the ball over. This will end really quickly. Move the ball downfield. If you're Edgewood, you've got to make a play here. You've got to pop the ball out. You've got to be looking to strip it. You've got to be looking to do more than just make a tackle. So DeForest will run their first play at 2 minutes and 5 seconds. Edgewood's going to draw a timeout before they're able to do so. So we'll be back in just a moment. But remember, 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter, 47-0, DeForest. Welcome back to high school football on channel3000.com. DeForest currently at 47-0 with 2 minutes and 1 second left to go. Hands the ball off to Mitch Hahn, who's got a lot of carries here in this second half. He'll get some good yardage there. Able to work on those off-tackle runs all day. The tackles for DeForest are just winning the battle on the ends and sealing those defensive ends and making it a wide open field for these running backs. So second and four, we're down to 1:30. Backup quarterback Jacobson in. He'll keep it, misdirection, works around the edge, takes a big shot on the sidelines, and another flag after a little bit of late jawing happened. You've got to assume that was as a result of Daniel James, some extracurricular words for the DeForest coaching staff there. So, again, unsportsmanlike conduct on Edgewood. A 15-yard penalty. And that's the result of playing good, clean football. When you've done that for a while, and you've been pounding a team like this all day, it becomes frustrating. It becomes overwhelming, and you can't do anything about it. And you have to keep your head. You can't give a team like DeForest 15 yards and allow them to finish off the game like this. So DeForest receives a first down. The clock is about to begin running with just a minute and 9 seconds left. They have a 47-0 lead. Some coordination between the officials. I think Edgewood head coach Jesse Norris wants an explanation on the penalty. Well, he certainly got one. Quick meeting between the referee and Jesse Norris of Edgewood. And we'll likely resume play here. So, again, fourth quarter, 47-0. A minute and 8 seconds left. Bryce Jacobson showing some real promise as the junior quarterback. Heir apparent to Schrader, who had a great first half. The offense was very smooth today. DeForest students here. Heavy attendance from them. The student section still very full and very loud. They're excited to see their Norskies pick up their first win of the 2019 season. And this will allow Jacobson to take a kneel. And the clock will continue to run. So likely this will be our final score, 47-0. Next week, DeForest will look on Fort Atkinson. They'll be on the road for the first time in the 2019 season, working their way through the Badger North Conference. And it looks like they'll have to take one more snap here, and then this win will be official. And so it is. So DeForest Area High School picks up their first win of the 2019 season on an impressive display of both offense and defense. It was a really incredible display for Mike Minnick's team. Thank you so much for joining us here. Again, the final score, 47-0. I'm Ole Yeager, and you've been watching Channel 3000.com High School Football.